What's up, guys? So it's early morning and just checking on some clutches that are getting close to pipping. And guess what? Bam, we got a pipper. So we're gonna go ahead and cut some eggs today and see what we have. Okay, so let's go get ready to cut. I've already cleaned my tools, got everything set up. I think I just need a towel or paper towel to make sure that any leakage I can go ahead and wipe off. But this is clutch number 9, guys, and I am really excited about this one. There's a couple of combos here that I really want to make, and I'm hoping to go ahead and hit them this season. So let me start cutting. I'll go work my way around, but this one is a bad egg. Obviously it's brown, and I usually just leave eggs, you know, alone unless it's a slug and it's not connected, so it's not causing anything else to mold. So I just kind of leave them there as it is. I don't know, just personal preference. I know someone commented, why leave it there? Why can't you just toss it? I don't know. Maybe I've always hoped that it would hatch, but you know, obviously it's not going to hatch now. So let's just go ahead and get it out. Put them in the dumpster. And voila. And from the goop, and we can go from there. So yeah, I probably shouldn't put any snakes on top of that, or eggs I should say. But as you guys maybe saw on the label, this is a Pasta Lesser Enchi Het Hypo to a calico female pairing, and I am looking forward to seeing some amazing babies on this pairing. At least a pastel lesser calico would be the minimum that I would want. All right, let's see. So for those new to the channel, this is, just cut them. Oh wow. Whoo. That's a nice one. Oh, come on. All that goop. That looks orange dream to me. It could be pastel calico. She may have had a retained sperm. I have to look at the records, but I don't remember putting the orange dream enchi in here. But that one looks orange dream. It could just be the coloration, but that's the nose is coming out right there. So once they usually work their way in the middle, as far as their head is right there in the center, that's when they really start just cutting through the eggs, just kind of open it up, you know, it's kind of something like that. But yeah, that is a really nice combo. Wonder what that would look like when it comes out and color up. So all right, let's go see what we have. Ooh, this one is something lighter. Oops, come on. All right, sorry about that. We got cut off, the alarm went off for some reason. I think we hit it right here. I think this one has enchi though. I don't know who hit the calico, but wow. This one's nice. Wow. Man, that is gorgeous. Hey there, little buddy. Yeah, he's just like, okay, I can't wait to see my little brothers and sisters. All right, so that one, I think, looks like an Enchi. The head looks very Enchi to me. So that looks promising. I'm not going to cut the entire top to make this thing faster. Nice. Another calico. And this one, I think, is a pastel calico. Possible Enchi. But, there. So, it's really high white. Let's see if we can disconnect you guys. Oh, this one's a big baby right here. Let's see what we have. So far, really good odds. And the biggest baby looks like a normal. Oh no. It's not a normal. I think it's an Enchi. There you go. I think it's a pastel Enchi. Maybe a twin in there? No. I've never hatched a twin. So, but that one, I believe, is at least a pastel Enchi. So that's still good. So far, cross my fingers, no normals. All right, so this next fat one. Yeah, this one's, I can feel it getting probably lots of cuts on top. This one's trying to get out already. Today's day 56, by the way, for this clutch. So I was actually really tempted to go ahead and cut this before they pip, but you know what? I just waited. So let's see. Oh, we got a big fat normal. Normal or calico. That's blushing. There is. You know what? I think this is a calico. And some calicos don't color up until much later. But I don't think this is a normal. I mean, it looks too bright to be a normal. So, but definitely not a pastel. All right, so let's go cut this. Cut you open, the rest of you. Ugh, goop. So the only thing about cutting eggs, it can get pretty messy. All right, come on. I think this one is a pastel. Pastel, possible Enchi. Can't see the head. But for now, could be pastel calico. Who knows? It's too bright to be just pastel, the banding. We'll see what else this one has, but it doesn't look exactly like this, but definitely something. Definitely at least pastel. This one right here, I believe, has Enchi. And I think it's got its head stuck. Can't get it. There you go. There you go, buddy. Oh, you got a little bit of blood dripped on you, huh? Okay, so let's just go around. There you go. Yeah, this one I think is at least a pastel Enchi. Yeah, pastel Enchi at least. Yeah, I don't think there's yellow belly in this pairing. I don't think the calico has yellow belly, and I don't think the male has yellow belly either. But definitely he's producing some really nice pastel combos on this one.
I was hoping I'd hit a little bit more
lesser in the clutch, but I only hit one. So that one, I hope, is a female. And if it is a female, that will be my holdback. Let me just cut the rest of this. But, wow. I think we did pretty good on this clutch. So far what I think is, this one I think is an Orange Dream Calico. I mean, I would have to look at her records, what I paired her with. Yeah, I only put one male. And it's the Pastel Enchi Lesser Het Hypo. That must have been a retained sperm, because last year I did pair her with an OD Enchi, but I got dual sire clutch. I had some calico Orange Dream, and the rest were bamboo combos. So, wow. I mean, that's a bonus. I wasn't expecting that. And if that's a female, I may have to just keep it too. But this one is gorgeous, and I hope it has calico in it, because that's really what I was hoping for to produce. I believe this one is a pastel calico, maybe Enchi, but not as prominent on the Enchi. So I'll wait until that comes out. That one's a pastel Enchi. See the difference in color on this? One of them's got to have something else. So, and I think that one's a normal possible calico, and then pastel Enchi on that one. At least these two look the same, so it could be this is an Enchi calico, who knows. But these two look very similar, and this is different, so it could be that one has calico, or these two are just pastel calicos, and this one is maybe a pastel Enchi calico. We'll see. We'll figure it out as soon as they will crawl out, and go from there. All right, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. If you guys haven't done so, smash that like button. Subscribe so you guys can get updates on more clutches that are hatching. We're deep into the breeding season. I have a few clutches that are going to be pipping again in the next 2 weeks. So I'm gonna have a little break here, let everyone shed, and then I'm gonna have another clutch hatching in about 2 weeks time. So maybe 10 days. So, all right, guys, thanks again for watching, and until next time.